أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ثم بعثنا من بعدهم موسى وهارون إلى فرعون وملئه بآياتنا فاستكبروا وكانوا قوما مجرمين. I refer to the point that here the word قوم has not been used. Why? Because you know previously the people were at a primitive level of social evolution. Homogeneous, you know, a tribe, homogeneous. No differentiations of the governors and the governed. But now, as you know, there was social evolution, you may call it, or devolution, you may call it, what happened, whatever you may call it, the changes in the social structure. Now, you know, society divided into two parts. The dominators, the dominant sections, and people, common masses, who just became ignorant. Mostly they became like, you know, beasts of burden. They didn't have any time to ponder over anything. This is what we can see, you know, with our own eyes in societies like, you know, Pakistan and so many other Muslim countries. Big landlords, they are the governors. They are the small kings of their estates. And the common men, in the same way, the chieftains of Balochistan. Common people, absolutely ignorant. And if some light comes to them, they obstruct it. They shouldn't get the light. Because they want to keep them exploited. So the oppressors and the oppressed, the exploiters and the exploited, this differentiation started. Here in this country, you have this oppression in another form. It's the capitalist. The capitalist can buy the media, the, you know, the press, everything, print media, electronic media. They have, you know, the money to buy them. And then they can befool the common man. Common man doesn't have more time to go into details and to know things for himself. If he has any time, that is also, you know, taken up by these amusements, as they call them. Befoolments, they should be called, you know. Because they are not allowed then. They don't have any time to think about the real things of the life. So this must be kept in mind. Summa ba'asna min ba'dihi Musa wa Haruna ila Fir'auna wa Malai. Then we sent after them Musa and Harun to Pharaoh and his chiefs. Bi'ayatina, with our signs. Now here they mean they do big miracles. Fastakbaru. They behaved arrogantly. Wakanu qawman mujrimeen. And they were a guilty people. Falamma ja'ahumul haqqu min indina. We have read these things, you know, in detail. When the truth came to them, from us, قَالُوا إِنَّ هَذَا لَسَحْرٌ مُبِينٌ. They said it's a clear sorcery. It's a magic. قَالَ مُوسَىٰ أَتَقُولُونَ لِلْحَقِّ لَمَّا جَاءَكُمْ أَسْحْرٌ هَذَا. Musa said to them, asked them, are you saying this for the truth that has come to you? Is it magic? Do you really think it is magic? وَلَا يُفْلِحُ السَّاحِرُونَ. And the magicians, they will never succeed. قَالُوا أَجِهْتَنَا لِتَلْفِتَنَا عَمَّا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهَا آبَانَا. Now those chiefs and Pharaoh, what they said, have you come to us so as to turn us away from what we found our forefathers practicing. وَتَكُونَ لَكُمَ الْكِبْرِيَاءُ فِي الْأَرْضِ And the dominion in the land, they should be for you both. You are aspiring for power. You want to drive us from this land and to govern and control this land through your magic. وَمَا نَحْنُ لَكُمَا بِمُؤْمِنِينَ And we are not going to believe in both of you. فَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ اُتُونِي بِكُلِّ سَاحِرٍ عَلِيمٍ And said Firaun, bring to me every expert magician, whosoever is knowledgeable, sorcerer, call him, gather them. فَلَمَّا جَاءَ السَّحْرَةُ قَالَ لَهُمْ مُوسَىٰ أَلْقُمْ أَنْتُمُ الْقُونَ When the magicians and sorcerers came, Moses said to them, now you cast what you are to cast. فَلَمَّا أَلْقَوْا And they cast. قَالَ مُوسَىٰ مَا جَيْتُمْ بِهِ السَّحْرِ Musa said, what you have brought and what you have produced is real magic. It's magic. Nothing more. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَيُبْتِلُهُ Very soon Allah will prove it to be false. Prove it to be vain. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُسْلِحُ عَمَلَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not let the work of mischief mongers prosper. وَيُحِقُّ اللَّهُ الْحَقَّ بِكَلِمَاتِهِ And Allah will prove the truth to be true through His words. وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْمُجْرِمُونَ Although the guilty people might not like it, they might abhor it. فَمَا آمَنَ بِمُوسَىٰ إِلَّا ذُرِّيَّتِهِ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ عَلَىٰ خَوْفٍ مِّنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَئِهِمْ This ayah is also one of the most misunderstood ayat of the Quran. مَلَئِهِمْ Most of the people have translated as Malaihi. Malaihi is singular. Chiefs of Fir'aun. Malaihim. Their chiefs. So this difference must be kept in mind. فَمَا مَنَ لِمُوسَىٰ إِلَّا ذُرِّيَّةٌ مِّنْ قَوْمِهِ From his own nation also, nobody believed in Moses except a few youth of his community. And there's an important point to note. As I told you in the beginning of Surah At-Tawbah, that the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was twofold. Al-Baisatul Khassa, Al-Baisatul Amma. Khassa for the idolaters or pagan Arabs of the Arabian Peninsula. Amma to the whole of humanity for all times to come till the doomsday. In the same manner, Moses was also sent with double, you know, advent. He was a rasul, full messenger towards Fir'aun and his chiefs. And also he was a rasul to his own people. You'll find in Surah Saf, وَقَدْ تَعْلَمُونَ أَنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَىٰ لِقَوْمِهِ لِمَا تُوْزُونَنِي وَقَدْ تَعْلَمُونَ أَنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ So there was two communities at that time, the Bani Israel, the children of Israel, which were oppressed, persecuted, badly. And you know, Fir'aun and his chiefs, they were the oppressors. So Musa was sent primarily to whom? This must be noted. His primary advent was towards Fir'aun wa Malai. To the Bani Israel, it was secondary. And it was like the mission of a Nabi. That is why from them he never said, believe me, obey me, or you will be destroyed. This time, you know, this is the way the messengers of Allah have been saying to the communities or the nations to whom they were sent. This he said to Fir'aun, but not to Bani Israel. Bani Israel, you know, some of them believed in him, some of them helped him, some of them, you know, at many a times, they didn't accept his command, refused. Just we have read in Surah Al-Ma'idah, the whole of the nation refused to go to war. But they were not said that now be ready, you will be exterminated. Was it said to them? No. So there's difference. his advent towards the Fir'aun and his chiefs, and his advent towards the Bani Israel. فَمَا آمَنَ لِمُوسَىٰ إِلَّا ذُرِّيَّةٌ مِّن قَوْمِهِ. From his own community, even from his own community, none believed in him except some youth. Now this is the importance of the youth. They must understand. For any revolutionary struggle, youth are the vanguard. They have the courage, the potential. The older people, you know, they have to look to their, you know, maslahat. What is to be done to my family and this and that, what will happen. But youth, they are relatively free. Whatever appeals them, they accept it. They are ready to sacrifice. Here also we find this word. إِلَّا ذُرِّيَّةٌ مِّن قَوْمِهِ. Some youth from his nation. عَلَىٰ خَوْفٍ مِّن فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَئِهِمْ. Due to fear from Fir'aun and their own chiefs, the chiefs of Bani Israel. This is actually what should be understood and which has been not been understood by most of the Mufassirin as well as the translators. Because they don't have this, you know, structure, this political structure. What happened in India, for example? The Britishers were ruling us. But then among us, from among the Indians, they chose some people. They gave them the titles, Sir and Khan Bahadur. And of these people were more loyal to the Britishers than to their own nations. And the biggest example is of Karun. Karun was from Bani Israel. But he was much near to Fir'aun. And he was against Moses. So actually, the people who are ruled, who are slaves, who are given to slavery, you know, their mentality changes. And people who are more cunning among them, they come near, they become more faithful, they serve the rulers. And they, you know, get the benefits out of them. So they become an oppressor medium for the nation, for their own nation. They become the agents of imperialism. Although they belong to the oppressed nation, but they become agents of the imperialists, of the governors, to suppress and control the governed people. So this is actually, min Fir'aun wa malaihim, even their own chiefs, because they were faithful. They wanted to go and have a position in the court of Fir'aun. So they should get a title from him. Maybe, you know, some jagir from him. Ay yaftinahum. Because they feared that Fir'aun and their own chiefs will persecute them. فَإِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ الْعَالِمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Verily, certainly, Fir'aun was tyrant on land. فَإِنَّهُ لَمِنَ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. And definitely he was from the extravagance. وَقَالَ مُوسَىٰ يَا قَوْمِ إِن كُنْتُمْ آمَنْتُمْ بِاللَّهِ فَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلُوا إِن كُنْتُمْ مُسْلِمِينَ. And so said Musa, alayhi salatu wassalam, O my people, if you have belief in Allah. Now note, Rasul is not mentioned here. They were a community who believed in Allah. He's not mentioning himself here. If you have real belief in Allah, فَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلُوا. So you must have faith in him, إِن كُنْتُمْ مُسْلِمِينَ. If you are real Muslims, if you have really submitted to Allah. فَقَالُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلُوا. And they said, okay, we put our faith and trust in Allah. رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْنَا فِتْنَةً لِلْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Oh, our Lord, don't make us a vehicle of trial for these evildoers, transgressors, you know. What does it mean? فِتْنَةً لِلْ. You have given them the freedom to persecute us. You are trying them, but on us, you know. But we call in Urdu, takhta-e mashq. Don't make us takhta-e mashq for these evildoers. Don't make us, you know, an article for their testing. You are testing them on us. So please, وَلَا تَجْعَلْنَا فِتْنَةً لِلْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ وَنَجِّنَا بِرَحْمَتَكَ مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. Then deliver us by your mercy, through your mercy, from these disbelieving people. وأوحينا إلى موسى وأخيه أن تبوا لقومكما بمصر بيوتا. And we send the revelation towards Musa and his brother Harun that you appoint for your nation, for your people, houses in Egypt. وَجْعَلُوا بُيُوتَكُمْ قِبْلَةً. And you make those houses, بُيُوتَكُمْ قِبْلَةً. They can be interpreted in two ways. I will let you know. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And establish salah and give glad tidings to the mu'mineen. This is just like the Baitul Arqam in Makkah. You know, Muslims were not able to go to the courtyard of, you know, Baitullah and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala openly over there in the beginning. So the Prophet had chosen and fixed and appointed Baitul Arqam, a house of a companion. There they used to gather. They used to hold meetings. There they could pray in congregation also. But the same instruction is being given here. It was given to Hazrat Musa because they couldn't pray to Allah openly under that tyrant Fir'aun. So we told them to appoint certain houses, certain dwellings. And then these dwellings, وَجْعَلُوا بُيُوتَكُمْ قِبْلَةً. This qibla can have two meanings. Either places of congregation. Because this man is also coming to this place. This man is also coming to this place. This person, this woman from this side is also. So this becomes qibla for them. So the place of congregation, which everybody is facing. And the second meaning is, you build your houses facing towards qibla. And this is actually a masterpiece of research done by Maulana Hamiduddin Farahi Rahmatullah Alayhi. He has written a book, Ar-Rayu Sahih Fi Man Huwa Zabih. And in that he had proved that even for Bani Israel, the Qibla was Baitullah. He has proved from quotations from the Old Testament that whenever they went, wherever they went, they built, fixed their tent of worship facing, directing the south. And to the south was this Baitullah. Because they were the progeny of Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam. Ibrahim had built this house. How could it be possible? They didn't know this is the Qibla. Their tent of worship, you know, Qurban Gah, they used to call it. Because there was more of sacrifice in their Sharia than of Salah. But you know, the altar was to be as if, you know, whosoever is presenting the sacrifice is facing south. And towards the south, it is from Palestine to Egypt. If you are facing towards south, it is the Qibla. It is the direction of the Baitullah. So this has been proved by him, Hamiduddin Farahi. You know, this book he wrote in Arabic, Ar-Rayu Sahih Fi Man Huwa Zabih, but it had been translated by Maulana Amir Hasan Islahi, one of his disciples, and it can be had from Pakistan. So this was the command given to them. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ وَأَخِيهِ تَبَوَّأَ لِقَوْمِكُمَا بِمِصْرَ بُيُوتًا وَاجْعَلُوا بُيُوتَكُمْ قِبْلَةً وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This is just like the Baitul Arqam of Makkah. فَقَالَ مُوسَى رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ آتَيْتَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَأَهُ زِينَةً وَأَمْوَالًا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا رَبَّنَا لِيُضِلُّوا عَن سَبِيلِكَ. And so said Musa, عليه الصلاة والسلام, O our Lord, you have given Fir'aun and his chiefs the adornment and wealth in the life of this world. O our Lord, so that they should lead the people astray. They have the authority, they have the power, they have the wealth, they have the money, they have all the adornments of this life. And with these, they are leading people astray from your path. You have given all these things to them. رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ آتَيْتَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَأَهُ زِينَةً وَأَمْوَالًا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا رَبَّنَا لِيُضِلُّوا عَن سَبِيلِكَ. What is the outcome of all this? They are obstructing people from coming to your path. they are forcibly turning them away because they have the authority. They have money to buy people. They can buy any agent from our own nation. Now this is also the final stage. When you know the messenger becomes so fed up with the nation, to the people whom he has been sent, that now he is giving, you know, this prayer for their azab. Rabbana tmis ala amwalihim. Oh our Lord, wipe away their riches. Washdud ala qulubihim. And harden their hearts. فَلَا يُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى يَرَوُوا الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمَ. So that they don't believe before the time of seeing of the painful torment. What does it mean? Now don't let them believe. If they come to believe now, they will be saved. They have persecuted us. They had done all the crimes. Now if you let them come to faith, they will be saved. Now you just put seals on their hearts. This is the prayer of the Prophet, of the Messenger. You put the seals on their heart. Washdud ala qulubihim. So that they don't now believe. They don't come to the faith, accepting the faith. Before their eyes see this azab, this torment coming. قَالَ قَدْ أُجِيبَتْ دَعْوَتُكُمَا فَاسْتَقِيمَا وَلَا تَتَّبِعَانِّ سَبِيلَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Allah replied, the prayer of you two has been granted. We have granted the prayer of you, your prayer. قَالَ قَدْ أُجِيبَتْ دَعْوَتُكُمَا فَاسْتَقِيمَا. Now you stand firm. وَلَا تَتَّبِعَانِّ سَبِيلَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And never follow the path of those who don't know. وَجَاوَزْنَا بِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْبَحْرِ. And we brought the children of Israel across the sea. فَأَتْبَعَهُمْ فِرْعَوْنُ وَجُنُودُهُ بَغْيًا وَعَدْوًا. Now, Fir'aun and his armies, they chased them. They followed them. Baghyan, rebelliously, wa'adwa and transgressively. Hatta iza adrakahu al-gharqu, till when the drowning overtook him, qala amantu annahu la ilaha illa alladhi amanat bihi banu Israel. Now we exclaim, oh, I come to believe in the Lord in whom the children of Israel believe. وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And I surrender, I submit. I am one of the surrenderers. آلان. What now? وَقَدْ عَصَيْتَ قَبْلُ وَكُنْتَ مِنَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. And you disobeyed. You have been disobeying before this. And you have been among the mischief mongers. فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ. Now today we shall rescue your dead body. Your badan, your body will be rescued and saved. لِتَكُورَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةً. So that it becomes a sign for those who are behind you. وَإِنَّ كَسِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا لَغَافِلُونَ. But you know, very many people from among humanity they don't pay any heed to our signs and revelations. وَلَقَدْ بَوَّعْنَا بِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ مُبَوَّعَ صِدْقٍ. وَلَقَدْ بَوَّعْنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ مُبَوَّعَ صِدْقٍ وَرَزَقْنَاهُ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ. And we settled the children of Israel in a secure settlement. And we provided them good things, pure. فَمَخْتَلَفُوا حَتَّى جَاءَهُمُ الْعِلْمِ. And they didn't disagree till that knowledge came to them. Hatta here has been interpreted by most of the Mufassireen as meaning illa min ba'de ma, wa ma khtalafu illa min ba'de ma ja'ahumul ilm. This is how mostly these words come in the Quran, but this is a peculiar exception. But most of the Mufassireen take it that hatta here means illa min ba'de ma ja'ah. So what will be the text? فَمَخْتَلَفُوا illa min ba'd ma ja'ahumul ilm. If they differed, it was only after that true knowledge and guidance had come to them. But it can have another meaning where we don't need to change the meaning of hatta here. وَمَخْتَلَفُوا They didn't disagree about the advent of the last messenger. They were all agreed upon that the last messenger is to come. But when that true knowledge came to them, then now they are differing. They all agreed. They were waiting. The Christians were waiting. The Jews were waiting. And you know, because they were saying to the Aus and Khazraj, the people of Medina, that the last prophet is near to come. And we shall be with him, and when we shall fight you, then you will not be able to be victorious over us. So that was the knowledge that these people of Aus and Khazraj gathered from the Bani Israel. And that is why, you know, the six of them, they immediately accepted Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he met them in this Aqaba, the valley of Aqaba, in the 10th year, after he returned from Taif. They looked to each other, oh, he seems to be the same person about whom these Jews go on talking. So they were all agreed upon. وَمَخْتَلَفُوا They didn't disagree about the advent of the last messenger of Allah, حَتَّى جَاهُمُ الْعِلْمُ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ يَقْزِي بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Now their Lord will give the verdict between them on the day of judgment, فِيمَا كَانُوا فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ in whatever they had been differing. وَاللَّهُ عَلَمْ فَإِن كُنْتَ فِي شَكٍ مِمَّا أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُ Here also I disagree with some, or let me say most of the translators at least. They think here in these ayat, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being addressed. While I think that it is the reader or the listener, he is being addressed. فَإِن كُنْتَ فِي شَكٍ If you are in a doubt, مِمَّا أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ About what we have sent down. Now this I could never accept it for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He could never be in doubt. So this is actually the people who were listening to these ayat, to these people to whom, you know, this guidance was directed. If you are really in any doubt about what I have sent down, فَسْأَلِ الَّذِينَ يَقْرَؤُونَ الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ So you can ask those people who were reading the book before you. There are the Jews, they live in Medina. You don't know about prophethood. It's something new for you. But you know you can go and you know, ask them, inquire from them. لَقَدْ جَاءَكَ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكَ This total truth has come to you. فَلَا تَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُمْتَرِينَ So you should never be among the doubters. وَلَا تَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الَّذِي كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ You should never be among those who denied and refuted the ayat of Allah, the revelation of Allah. فَتَكُونَ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ Then you will become from among the losers. I don't accept that these words can be directed or addressed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ حَقَّتْ عَلَيْهِمْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ Verily, those on whom the verdict of your Lord has already fallen, already come. The seal on their heart has already been set by your Lord. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ حَقَّتْ عَلَيْهِمْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ They are not going to believe. وَلَوْ جَاتُمْ كُلُّ آيَةٍ Although all the signs might come to them, never think that if the signs and miracles are shown to them, they will come to believe. حَتَّى يَرَوُ الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمِ Only if there is any, you know, chance, when they see the torment with their own eyes, then they will come to believe, just as Pharaoh, you know, believed when, you know, drowning had overcome him. فَلَوْلَا كَانَتْ قَرْيَةٌ آمَنَتْ Bada, here you know again the words should be understood. Bada is Raat il Azab. Why was not there any township? Laula kanat qaryatun amanat fanafaha imanuha. So that its iman would have benefited it. Illa qawma Yunus. Except the people of Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. What does it mean? After the signs of the torment start. Now the gates of Tawbah, repentance are closed. This is the law. After the signs of death start, for an individual, the gates of Tawbah, gates of repentance are closed. In the same way, when to the nation or the community to whom a messenger was sent, and they rejected, denied, belied, and now when the signs of the torment, of the punishment started, they said, woe, we believe. Now it was not acceptable. Except for one. There is an exception. And that's the people of Jonah. Hazrat Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. I will give you the answer why. Why this exception? There should be some exception. If the exception is there, there must be some reason for it. But this is the meaning of the ayah. فَلَوْلَا كَانَتْ قَرْيَةٌ آمَنَتْ. But here you should think that the words are understood. فَلَوْلَا كَانَتْ قَرْيَةٌ آمَنَتْ بَعْدَ إِزْرَاتِ الْعَذَابِ فَنَفَاهَا إِمَانُهَا. This has never been the case that a nation, if it accepted the faith after seeing the signs of the punishment, فَنَفَاهَا إِمَانُهَا, and its iman, its believing, would have benefited him. No, there was never. Illa qawm Yunus, except the people of Yunus. Lamma amanu, when they believed, they repented, kashafna anhum azab al-khizy. We removed from them the chastisement of degradation and humiliation, fil hayat al-dunya, in the life of this world, wa matta'nahum ilaheen, and we provided them, and we gave them a fresh lease of existence for a fixed period of time. Now, what was the reason? You know, we have read the ayah in the beginning of Surah Al-A'raf. فَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. And I explained at that time that this trio, Allah sends the message to a nation through the messenger. If the messenger fulfills his duty, the all responsibility goes to the people. If somehow the messenger fails to fulfill the duty, the people get a credit. Just like the modern accounting. For each entry, there must be a corresponding entry. For each credit, a debit, corresponding debit. For each debit, a corresponding credit. So now there was a discredit to Hazrat Yunus alayhi salam. Why? He left his people without the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for this he was punished. He was swallowed by the fish, the big fish. Maybe some whale. Then vomited on the coast. وَهُوَ سُقِيم. And you know, he begged. He begs the pardon of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimeen. This was the mistake he committed. So the discredit became a credit for the nation. Because your messenger left you earlier, then we had allowed him to leave. We had our express permission had not come. You must have read in the seerah, you know, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he allowed most of the Muslims to go to Medina, to Yathrib. But he was withholding himself, not going. He was waiting for the express permission of Allah to leave. And this is always, the executive officers can't leave their place of duty without express permission. They are the executives. They have to control the things here. They can't go. They can't leave. Subordinates can go. But the executives, they can't leave. So the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they cannot leave their nation without the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was, you know, a mistake. Done out of absolutely sincerity, faithfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He became very much outraged. Why these people are not accepting? They are doomed. Okay, I'm going. Mughaziban. Is zahaba mughaziban. But this ghazab was against not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ma'azanda. This ghazab was against the nation. They are doomed. And I'm going. But the express permission had not come. So this is the reason. But on this, you know, I infer we can also hope to have this concession. Why? Because to us today, no infallible and innocent messenger of Allah is preaching. So we can claim a concession from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just as you gave a concession to the people of Yunus, alayhi salatu wassalam. But this is my idea, you may agree or disagree. وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَعَامَنَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كُلُّهُمْ جَمِيعًا. And had your Rabb decreed or decided, all would have come to believe. All of them, كُلُّهُمْ جَمِيعًا. They are all under our control. According to the saying of the Prophet, the hearts of all human beings are within the two fingers, between the two fingers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can turn them in whichever direction He wants. So actually we can do it. But we are testing the people. We are seeing who wants to be guided, who doesn't want to be guided. Who wants to be guided, we shall guide them. Who don't want, well, we shall let them go their way. وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ إِلَّا لَآمَنَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمْ كُلُّهُمْ جَمِيعًا أَفَأَنْتَ تُكْرِهُمْ نَاسَ حَتَّى يَكُونُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ. So will you, O Muhammad, compel people till they become real Muslims, they become Muslims and Mu'mins? There is no ikraah fi deen. As we have in Surah Al-Baqarah, ikraah fi deen. At individual basis, full liberty. You are free to believe and you are free to not believe. Imma shakiram wa imma kufura. You can take any way. Had there been no choice, freedom of choice, there couldn't be any question of any reward or any punishment for that matter. So, at individual basis, no compulsion, no coercion. But the system, political, socio-economic system, that is a different thing. If the Muslims have power, they must change it. And they must try to gather power. عِدُّ لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَعَتُمْ. To be able to change this system and establish the rule of Allah. But then, all the non-Muslims will be allowed. If they want to accept Islam, okay, welcome. We are ready to embrace. But if you don't, you can remain as Jews, as Christians, as Hindus, as Buddhists, etc. وَمَا كَانَ لِنَفْسٍ أَن تُؤْمِنَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. And it was not possible for any soul to have faith except with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I told you there can be nothing. I cannot lift this without the permission of Allah. So how can one believe? But I intended to lift it. The permission came from Allah. I can say I lifted, and I can say Allah made me to lift it. So both these things mean the same. مَا كَانَ النَّفْسُ أَن تُؤْمِنَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَيَجْعَلُ الرِّجْسَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. And Allah puts filth, impurities, on those people, abominations on those people who don't use their intellect. قُلْ انظُرُوا مَاذَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Say to them, now look, what is there in all the heavens and then the earth? وَمَا تُغْنِ الْآيَاتُ وَالنُّذُرُ عَنْ قَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And all these signs of ours, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ, these are all signs, divine signs. وَالنُّذُرُ, and all the warners, أَنْقَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, they will not be of any avail to those people who don't want to believe. فَهَلْ يَنْتَظِرُونَ إِلَّا مِثْلَ أَيَّامِ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. So what are they waiting for except the days like the days of the ancient people who were before them? You are waiting for the days like the days of Hud, like the days of Saleh. The nation of Saleh, the nation of Hud, the people of Nuh. فَهَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا مِثْلَ أَيَّامِ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. And these you know, days are termed in Quran in another place, أَيَّامِ اللَّهِ فَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. Remind them, referring to the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The day when the whole of the nation of Nuh was drowned. The days when whole of the nation of Aad was finished, done away with. The days when whole of the nation of Samud, so strong a nation, was exterminated. Ayyamullah. قُلْ فَانْتَذِرُوا إِنِّي مَعَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُنْتَذِرِينَ. Say, okay, if you want to wait, go on waiting. I am also waiting with you. I am also among the waiters. ثم ننجي رسلنا والذين آمنوا كذلك. And then we shall save and deliver our messengers and those who come to believe. In the same way, in the same way in which we delivered Nuh and his companions, Hud and his companions, Saleh and his companions, Lut and his family, Shu'aib and his companions, Moses and Bani Israel. ثم ننجي رسلنا والذين آمنوا كذلك حقا علينا ننجي المؤمنين. This is an obligatory thing upon us, obligatory, that we will deliver and save the people who come to believe. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِن كُنْتُمْ فِي شَكٍّ مِّن زِينِي. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these are the concluding ayat of this surah. If you are in some doubt about my deen, you are compelling me to come back from this deen, to come to your folds again, to come to the beliefs and dogmas of the forefathers. So you, and it means you are still in doubt about me. That maybe that I accept your compulsion or your coercion. I give in. Maybe I, you know, turn my back to what I have been saying for the 10 years. In kuntum fi shakkin min deeni. If you are harboring even the slightest doubts about my deen, fala abudul ladina ta'buduna min dunillah. I am not going to worship those whom you are worshipping instead of Allah. وَلَكِنْ أَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ الَّذِي يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ. I will go on worshipping and obeying Allah, who will take possession of your souls, who will put you to death. وَأُمِرْتُ وَنَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And I have been commanded to be among the believers. وَأَنْ أَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ لِلْدِينِ حَنِيفًا. And O Prophet, set your face steadfast for the religion, for the deen. As an upright man of pure faith, Hanif, وَلَا تَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And you shouldn't be from among the associators, those who associate others with Allah. Now these ayat can be addressed to the Prophet also, and to any listener or reader. They are, you know, general. وَاقِنْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا يَا أَيُّهَا السَّامِعُ. Or وَاقِنْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ. These two, both, you know, they are absolutely equal. وَلَا تَدْعُ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُكَ وَلَا يَضُرُّكَ. This again is for the سامِع and the listener and the reader. And don't pray and don't call upon those who cannot benefit you, who cannot do you any harm, except Allah. فَإِنْ فَعَلْتَ فَإِنَّكَ إِذًا مِّنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. If you do that, you will also be from among the evil doers. وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِدُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ. And if Allah afflicts you with some hurt, nobody can remove it except Him. وَإِنْ يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِهِ. In the same way, if He intends for you something good, pleasant, then nobody can turn back or obstruct His bounty. يُسِيبُ بِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. He gives and bestows His bounty on whomsoever He likes from among His bondsmen. وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. And definitely, He is Al-Ghafoor, the forgiving, Ar-Rahim, the merciful. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَكُمُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Say, O mankind, the total truth has come to you from your Lord. فَمَنْ اِهْتَدَى فَإِنَّمَا يَهْتَدِي لِنَفْسِهِ. So whosoever takes to the right path, he does so in his own interest, to his own benefit. وَمَنْ ضَلَّ فَإِنَّمَا يَدِلُّ عَلَيْهَا. And who goes astray? Well, he is doing it against his own self. He is putting his own self into loss and into doom. وَمَا أَنَا عَلَيْكُمْ بِوَكِيلْ. I am not a ward, or I am not a guardian over you. I am not responsible about you. وَتَّبِعْ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ. The last words to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And follow whatever is being revealed to you. وَصْبِرْ. And persevere. Have patience. حَتَّى يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ. Until Allah gives His command his decision, his all judgment, وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. And definitely, he is the best of the judges. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.